Are you just starting your journey with myopia reduced lens method to get your eyesight back completely naturally and get rid of your glasses? These are five tips that I think are so important to have in your toolbox when you want to start this method successfully. I learned from it, from starting this 2 years ago and going from minus 5.5 to minus 2.75 diopters. And in this video, I want to share with you five tips that I think are so important when trying to be successful at a myopia reduced lens method from the beginning. So let's get into it. Tip number one is to learn the science. I think it is so important to learn the science behind myopia, behind your eyes getting elongated. I think it is so important to understand also what might be happening when we are wearing our reduced prescription, our normalized or our differentials, and we're trying to get our eyeballs back from elongated to slowly getting back to its shape. So I think learning the science is so important. Reading the literature papers, even if you don't think that you're a very scientific person, just reading the abstracts or using the resources to learn about the science, I think is so important when first trying to do the myopia reduced lens method. And it is especially important if you're doing the whole free DIY approach. If you're doing the paid programs, I'm sure there are resources out there for you, and it's kind of all integrated. That's what I would assume in the program. But if you're doing the whole free DIY approach, it's so important to learn about the science so that you can troubleshoot yourself out of situations, and also know that if you're not getting results, it's not because the method is wrong, it's most likely because you're doing it wrong. And that is a tough pill to swallow, but I've been there. I thought, why in the world am I doing this wrong? Why is this not working? It turns out I was not following the method properly, and also I wasn't understanding the science. So learning the science, I think, is so important. If I ever make a video on the science, I'll link it here. But for now, I have included the links in the description. Please go check them out and learn about the science. Second tip is to get rid of your phone. So I know there's no way that we can get rid of our phones nowadays. You got Google Maps. What am I going to do with Google Maps? I'm not saying throw away your phone. I'm just saying for a period of time, get rid of your phone. Like, don't look at it. Don't look at it for anything unless it is absolutely essential. And that could be for a few days. It could be for a month. You could take a phone fast. I take phone fasts here and there where for maybe a week or so, I will not look at my phone unless I'm calling someone or if I'm lost and I need Google Maps. So getting rid of your phone at the beginning of when you're starting this myopia reduced lens method is so important, because you are going to understand how bad your phone is for your eyesight. And if you absolutely have to look at your phone, I would say use your differential glasses and bring it to the distance that you are, that is your computer distance. And so I think it's so important to get rid of your phone. And even if you can't get rid of it forever, of course, like I look at my phone nowadays, but I know when my eyes get worse, and I know what effect my phone has on my eyesight. But at the beginning, when you're first starting, it's so hard to know. Is my eyes not improving because I had bad sleep? Are my eyes not improving because I'm not wearing the right glasses? I don't know how to find active focus. Like, what is it? When you're trying to troubleshoot all of that, getting your phone out of the equation is so important, because most likely your phone is the thing that's going to give you really bad vision for that day. Okay, so that is my huge recommendation, is to get rid of your phone at the beginning. Really control your usage. And really with the phone, it's just, it's so small. And I mean, I have an iPhone mini, so it's even smaller for me, but it's so small, the screen is so small. And so it makes you look even closer, bring it closer to your face to look at it. And I even put that, the iPhone, there's this setting that you can put where it tells you if you're within a good safe distance to look at it. And honestly, even right now, I'm seeing more than 30 centimeters. I'm seeing like 32 to 33 centimeters of clarity on a bad day and 35 centimeters of clarity on a good day. And there are so many times where I'm looking at my phone and I think it's a good distance, but that the setting tells me that it's too close to my face. So get rid of your phone at the beginning. It's going to help you a lot. So the third tip that I have for you is to do the zero diopter reset properly. Don't just take your new normalized or your new differential glasses and pop them on your face and expect that to work. You're going to get headaches. You're going to be confused about why it's not working, why it's taking you so long to adjust to these glasses. Just do a complete zero diopter reset. Take the whole day if you need to. Walk around without glasses. I mean, in a safe way, when you're at home or you're outside in your neighborhood. Don't drive, please, when you're doing zero diopter reset, but just really take your time with it. Don't rush it. That is so important, I think. So tip number four is to measure your eyesight using the centimeter measurements. It is so important to understand where you are in your progress, and not measuring your eyesight is going to be really difficult when you're trying to troubleshoot, or when you're trying to figure out why you're not improving, or even when you're trying to do a reduction and you want to just double check that you are at measuring where you are supposed to be measuring at. So doing the centimeter measurements is so important. At the beginning, when I first started this, it was so weird for me to accept that the centimeter measurements actually works. And it was a really new concept, but it literally works. You just take your measuring tape and you stand in front of printed text and you measure what distance you can see until there's this tiny little bit of blur, and you write that down. So I'll put some links in the description about how to do this, so more resources, but essentially it is a fantastic way to measure your progress. And I am not going to the optometrist. Like, maybe I went to the optometrist once throughout doing this whole process, and I'll go and see them again maybe later, maybe next year or something. But using the centimeter measurements, it is perfect to understand where you're at. So tip number five is to get rid of nearsighted habits. And this is so important, and it is going to take time. I know for me, it took me some time to get rid of some of my bad habits. Some of the bad habits I had were, one, using my distance vision glasses to look up close, two, looking at my phone way too much, spending too much time looking at screens. Even when I was working, I would spend way too much time looking at my computer, and I would not take breaks at all. And also other habits of when I was outside, I would look down instead of looking at the distance. So a lot of these little habits that lead to a nearsighted lifestyle, you want to get rid of them, because you're on your journey to become not nearsighted, which is why I named my YouTube channel Not Nearsighted, because I don't want to be nearsighted anymore. So you're on your journey to not be nearsighted anymore. You need to get rid of the habits that are keeping you nearsighted and replacing them with habits that are not nearsighted. I don't want to say farsighted, because that kind of means that you can't see up close. You want to see up close and the distance, okay? That's our goal here. We want to see everything. So getting rid of nearsighted habits is so important, and the top ones are looking at your phone, too much screen use, spending too much time indoors. And I know this can be tricky, because sometimes, let's say you live in a place where you can't go outside, maybe in the middle of winter that much, but honestly, just trying to maybe look out the window more often, not spending too much time looking, spending a lot of time like in this distance. We want to get rid of that. And especially at the beginning, you want to really work on your habits, because that is when you're trying to understand your eyesight, you're trying to understand how this method works, you're trying to get into a habit and into a flow of doing this and myopia reduced lens method. You want to remove any obstacles, and nearsighted habits are just obstacles. They're going to keep you where you're at. They're going to not really help. They're not going to help you improve. Okay, looking at your phone is not going to help you improve your eyesight. It's not. That is so important to get rid of your nearsighted habits, especially at the beginning when you're just starting out. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope that you got something from it. Let me know if you have any tips that you would add to this list that you think is absolutely important if you're starting the myopia reduced lens method today. And I'll see you next time.